Hey everyone, in today's video, we're going to talk a little bit about content planning. Now, this exercise can be great if you're creating a new website or planning a campaign or just trying to take stock of where the content for your business or organization is currently at. To help make it easier for myself and all of you, I made a little template in Google Workspace that you can use. The link is below, and I'll show you how I like to use it in my process right now. So this is my Google Draw document. The link is below. First thing I'm gonna do is make a copy, like it says in the title here. So you just go File, Make a Copy, and name it. Now, I call this the Content Ecosystem Doc because what we're essentially trying to do is just map all of the places that our content is gonna live. So when we go to plan our strategy and our tactics, we have an overview of all the places that our content can live. The first thing I'm gonna do is just zoom out so that I can see the whole thing. You'll see on the left side here, I have some of the more standard content placements already put in here. I'm gonna delete this instruction tab and just zoom in a touch. So down the left-hand side here, I have the main places most businesses or organizations will have to put content out to. And then for some of the social networks, I also have the formats. What we're looking to do here is just keep track of the platform as well as the formats that we currently post to. And perhaps we're even going to add in the ones that we hope to post to if we're making a campaign or a content strategy. What I'm going to do is just use my personal items as an example. So I have a website, so I'm going to drag that in there. And I'm just going to put trembath.com. I'll make it a little bigger so you can read the whole URL, and I'll just drop it in the center here. In my case, and in the case of most businesses, the website is the core place for driving traffic to. So I'm going to put it at the top of the page here, and then I'm going to fill in some of the networks that I'm currently using to promote my content and myself. I have a LinkedIn, I have Facebook, though it's mostly personal, I could drive traffic from that. I also have Twitter, where I often talk about marketing, and the YouTube, which you're currently watching. These other ones, in this case, I don't really want to use them in my strategy, so I will just leave them. If you have others that aren't listed here, you can just take this blank box, fill it in, choose a color. For this example, we're going to talk about how I'm going to promote this video. So on LinkedIn, I will probably post it in a group on my own timeline. And I probably will not make a LinkedIn post for it. But if I did, I would also drop it there. So I'm just going to center these so it looks nice. For tweet, you see this template is a bit old. It still has the fleets in there. I think that was a short-lived move. I could probably change that to threads and drop it in here. And then I'm also going to post it on my Facebook timeline. And for YouTube, there's the video, and then I will also make a short for it. Let's slide this over here. At a high level, this is my content delivery architecture. So now I have a high level map of where my content is going to live, and I'm just going to draw the lines here to show that these are coming inward to my website. So this video is going to live here on YouTube, but I also like to make a blog post on my website just to help establish a little bit of SEO content there. I like to put an arrow on just to show which direction the traffic is flowing. And now we can talk a little bit about what's going to go where. It's going to start as a video that lives primarily on YouTube. So for this particular exercise, I'm gonna highlight it yellow so that I can remember where my primary piece is coming. Now, even just from this, I have a much clearer picture of what content needs to be produced to promote this video. Once the video is done, I'm gonna also have to produce a tweet, perhaps outlining the steps that I just went through. I'm also going to write a timeline post for my Facebook, a timeline post for my LinkedIn with the additional hashtags, and I'm going to share it in one of the marketing groups that is specific to the content that we're sharing here today. Before I can do any of that, I'm also going to need to generate a blog post for my website that has some of the text from what I've said here and the video link so that you could watch it if you don't feel like reading. And that's pretty much it. Now that you have a diagram of where the content lives, you can share it with your team, and when you're ideating on what you're going to produce, you have a clear visual representation of all the assets that need to be created and where they're going to point to. Now, this was a pretty simple example. For a more complex campaign or a really large content project, obviously that diagram is going to be quite a bit bigger. So take the concepts presented here and apply them to your own content project. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. In a future video, I'll show you how to take this map to create a copy deck where everyone can contribute to the text or the assets required to fill all of these content placements, and to make sure your content project is organized and super easy to execute. As I said, the link is below, so just take the template, make a copy, and try it out for your own project. If you do have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and I'll do my best to answer them and help you get to the perfect plan.